Now let us see how we can use the file transfer protocol to download some files present on a server or to upload some files from our side to the server. So for this, I'm using a server speedtest.tele2.net. So this is a publicly available server for doing some experimentation. So this particular server will be useful for us to understand how FTP can be used for this. So once you to initiate the exchange of data between this server, you can use either FileZilla or Windows Secured Copy software. In short, we call it as WinSCP. So I have installed WinSCP on my computer. I am opening that application now. So once you open the application, so this is how the GUI, graphical user interface, for this WinSCP. Please do remember, this is one of the tools. Similar tools are available, like FileZilla, I said. So this is a tool can work on the Windows operating system. If you want to work it on the Linux, you can use the FileZilla. The interface more or less looks like this. So now let us connect to the remote server using FTP. So here I am selecting the FTP protocol, and by default it implies that it is a no encryption. That's what it is, unsecured data communication happens between the client and the server, and the FTP protocol runs on the port number 21. So when I'm using FTP, I can go for anonymous login, and the host name will be my server domain name, speedtest.tele2.net. So speedtest.tele2.net. This is a domain name. That's what I like to connect to this server remotely. So for this, the FTP, now a connection request has been made and it is starting a session, and they're reading the remote directory available on the server. So once it has been connected, now you can see the left side of my GUI indicates the my host systems. You can select whatever the directory you like to use it for you to transfer the documents. And the right side indicates the remote servers documents available. These are the sample files. Of course, they're all zip files. There is a provision to upload from your computer to the server, or you can download the files which are available on this server. So I am just downloading 1kb.zip file from the speedtest.tele2.net server onto my client machine. So just select the file and drag it onto your system. Now it starts downloading that particular file. Depending on the internet speed, usually it takes some time to get downloaded. Suppose in between the connection is lost, you please reconnect it, because it requires the connection to be maintained. But this is a public server. It is free for us to understand. The connection sometimes get lost, the session gets lost. Yes, now the file has been received onto my local host system. Similarly, if you want to have transfer or means get the downloaded file of 1 MB sizes, so you can simply select it and drag it. It all depends on the internet speed, the time taken to download that particular file. So you can, like this, you can as well as upload your files from your system, select it and upload onto this server. So this is basically you are using the FTP. So remember, here I'm not, user authentication is not there and it is unsecured way. So since this is just a dummy files, I was able to establish the connection with FTP. You can as well practice with SFTP to transmit the data across the internet using this SFTP. So now let me just close this one and Let us see, you know, coming back to our slides. So the next topic is on telnet, a teletype network. So it will be continued. So once you complete these discussions, let us see. Here we have something called SSH. So how do you make a SSH connection to be established? So to understand the practical demonstration of this secure shell protocol usage, you can use the tool, the simple tool putty.exe on the Windows platform as well as on the Linux platforms. Similarly, there is a terminal can be established, and this terminal can be used for free on the server sdf.org. So here you can either use the putty.exe or you can use your web browser to connect to this sdf.org to perform the SSH data transfers. Let me show you with ssh.sdf.org. So simply click that link. So once you click the link, it goes to ssh.sdf.org with the port number 4443. It is a secure connection protocol. So I have a login account. Once you have the login credentials over there, you can log into this particular server. So I will issue the password. So there is a broken connection is there. One second, I'll try for this one. Yes. Once a connection is established, you get to the prompt here. Now you can see the prompt. So you are connected to the remote server securely, and you can transfer the data to that server and get back the data. So once you get the prompt, means you are able to issue the commands for you to retrieve the files or send the files from your side. So this is one way to connect to the SSH. If you want to connect to another way using PuTTY, so open the PuTTY application, which is installed on your computer. So once you open the PuTTY So I think the screen sharing problem is there for the PuTTY. So basically the PuTTY also, the interface looks similar to the WinSCP. You have to enter your host name or the IP address and click the open, then provide the username and the password. Then a secure shell connection will be established. Okay, thank you.